Morning students, welcome to BS7 Geology class. So in the last video, we were talking about water canal system in sponges. Water canal system in sponges. So we already discussed two types of water canal systems, ascanoid and cyclinoid type. Ascanoid and cyclinoid type. Today we are going to talk about another type of water canal system known as leuconoid water canal system. So this diagram explains you the structure of simplest form of water canal system, that is the ascanoid type. Ascanoid type of water canal system is present in mucosolania polythus. Okay, mucosolania. So it's very simple. Normal ostia here, normal ostia open. Through the normal ostia, water enters into sponge seal. Sponge seal. Here, sponge seal is very wide and it is lined by choanocyte layer. So in the next type of water canal system, it is a bit complicated. All of the sponges are folded. The sponge seal forms outward pockets, pocket-like structures lined by choanocyte layer. So this is outward folding of wall of the sponge takes place. As a result, the flagellated cell-lined chambers are formed. These are flagellated, chambers. These chambers are lined by choanocyte layer. Here, sponge seal is not lined by choanocyte layer. It is also lined by the epidermal layer. Okay. Here, the sponge seal is lined by choanocyte layer. But as here, it is not lined by choanocyte layer, because choanocyte layer is forming folds, outward flow or folds, and these folds form chambers. The wall is folded like this. Can you see it? Folded. And as I said, you can see one more canal, development of one more canal called incurrent canal. Incurrent canal is present in between two adjacent flagellated chambers. So incurrent canal is alternated with the flagellated chamber. Is alternated by incurrent canal. These incurrent canal open to the exterior through normal ostia. Here, water current flows through normal ostia, incurrent canal, then prosopiles, hypopiles, the flagellated chamber, hypopiles, and sponge seal. Okay, it is a bit complicated. The flow of water is not straight as it is seen in case of ascanoid type. In cyclinoid type, it takes more turns. Water current takes more turns. Here in the cyclinoid type. And one more type is there, leuconoid type. Leuconoid type is much complicated. Due to the process of outward folding of wall of the sponge, more complicated water canal system is developed. In leuconoid type of sponges. See, look here, the flagellated chambers are formed like this. The wall of the sponge is much thicker than the cyclinoid type. It is this much, whereas here, very large. And that thickness is because of what? Because of the development of flagellated chambers. So flagellated chambers together form bunch-like structure
and these perforated chambers open into the exparent canal. Exparent canal. Okay, this is exparent canal. Can you see? This is exparent canal. So these are perforated chambers. Perforated chambers are connected to the exterior through incurrent canal. Incurrent canal open to the exterior through dermal ostium. Dermal ostium. Okay. So these are prosopoils. Incurrent canal open into the perforated chambers through prosopoils, and perforated chambers open into exterior canal through apophyses. Apophyses. Then this is exterior canal and several exterior canal together form the main canal, which opens to exterior through ostium. Ostium. Okay. So these pouches are not having a definite shape. They are irregular in shape. Irregular in shape because of much thickening of the wall of the sponge, and it is more efficient type of water canal system. Through these canals, water movement is not so fast as we see in case of say astrotype and cyclotype. It is slow but more efficient. Okay, so here in neurotype, the course of water current is like this. Dermal ostia, from the dermal ostia, water enters into incurrent canal. Incurrent canal, from incurrent canal, prosodas is present. Prosodas means the tubular structures which open into flagellated chambers. Suppose this flagellated chamber is like this. So this is incurrent canal, this is prosodas, flagellated chamber, and this is apophyses. Apophyses, next exterior canal, external canal. So in some other forms of sponges, it is a bit more complicated. There, the incurrent canal is opened into another type of canal before opening into flagellated chamber called prosodas. Here, prosodas is absent. Okay, flagellated chamber. From flagellated chamber, water enters into another tubular structure called apophyses. But here, apophyses is lacking. From apophyses it goes to exterior canal. So dermal ostia, incurrent canals, prosodas, prosopoils, flagellated chambers, then apophyses, apophyses, exterior canals, larger canals, osculum, and downward. So this is how the water is moving. So thus, the water canal system is the beauty of sponges. Sponges only have water canal system. Okay? And this water canal system, what it does? What are the functions of water canal system? Water canal system brings food substances, food organisms, oxygen, and supply them to the body cells, to the sponge, and in turn, they remove carbon dioxide, nitrogen waste, undigested food material to the exterior, and sex cells are also excreted out through the outgoing water. Thus, the water canal system in sponges helps in digestion, helps in respiration, helps in excretion, helps in reproduction. In digestion, it supplies the food organisms, then it removes undigested food material, excretion. Okay, respiration, it supplies oxygen and removes carbon dioxide. Reproduction. Reproduction, what it does? It carries, you know, sex cells, male sex cells, sperms from one sponge to another sponge for fertilization. Okay, this is how the water canal helps sponges performing various physiological functions.